thanks for watching Proactive New York. Westwater Resources has published its second quarter results. It's also got an update on its Kellyton graphite processing plant currently under construction in East Central Alabama. Joining us more are Executive Chairman Terence Cryan and incoming Chief Financial Officer Steve Cates. Terence, Steve, very good to speak with you today.
Good to be here.
So Steve, let me start with you. Can you take us through the financial highlights for the quarter?
Yeah, so at the end of the second quarter, we finished with another quarter with a strong balance sheet of $109 million cash on hand and no debt. So it was a really, really good quarter for us. We continued to progress the phase one construction. We spent on the first half of the year about $24.5 million in cash and really continued to make a lot of progress at the plant site for phase one.
Well, Terence, let me bring you in there. How is the progress going at Kellyton? And are you still aiming for completion of phase one mid-2023?
You know, this is definitely a challenging environment to be building a plant of any type. But I'm really pleased with the progress that we're making at Kellyton. You know, we began construction in the fourth quarter of last year. We moved quickly to order long lead time items, recognizing the supply chain issues that exist in the world today. On site, making really good progress. Investors may recall that we purchased two buildings on the periphery of the site last year, comprising 90,000 square feet of warehouse space. We've completed the refurbishment of those two buildings. So, you know, we're off to a great start. Site prep is moving along really well. And, you know, we're beginning to see, you know, vertical construction on the other buildings begin. So, we're managing this on an hourly and daily basis. There are going to be challenges throughout this process, but very pleased with where we stand at the present time. And, you know, we're still targeting to initiate commissioning of the plant mid-year 2023.
Steve, you mentioned the cash and working capital position. I think $109 million in cash, $102.7 million in working capital at the end of June. I mean, just given the inflationary pressures that we are seeing at the moment, how comfortable are you with the construction costs at this stage for Kellyton?
Yeah, so a couple things to keep in mind when related to that. The overall budget for phase one is $202 million. At the end of last year, and the beginning of this year, we put in orders for a number of long lead items that have continued to progress. We've actually started to receive a couple of those already. And so we try to get out ahead of inflation as much as we can. We continue to battle that similar to the supply chain challenges on a daily basis. But where we sit today, we've incurred $30 million of the $202 million since inception of the project to date as of 6/30. And what we're seeing right now, we still feel like the $202 million is our current guidance and our budget for the remainder of the project.
I mean, Terence, I mean, following the end of the second quarter, I noticed that you have signed a letter of intent with a global manufacturer of consumer batteries. So already lining up buyers for your product.
You know, we recognize that qualification process for battery materials is a lengthy one. And so we actually put our commercial sales team in place more than 2 years ago, really to try to, you know, begin to develop those relationships, be in a position to provide potential customers with samples from our pilot plant. And, you know, that process is underway, very active with, you know, more than a dozen different potential customers. We have a number of letters of intent already in place. We expect, you know, more in the months to come, because our goal is really to be, you know, fully committed to customers for our output from Kellyton as we commission the plant next year.
What can investors expect for the remainder of this year at Terence?
So again, we'll continue to provide, you know, investors with regular updates on, you know, progress in terms of our construction, updates with regard to progress with regard to customer contracts and letters of intent, and also importantly, some meaningful updates with regard to our Coosa graphite deposit. Now, our graphite deposit at Coosa, which is approximately 30 miles away from our Kellyton plant, is not scheduled to come online until 2028. but we've been actively developing that resource. We finished a drilling program earlier this year. We expect to produce a resource model for the deposit in the next few months. And so investors can expect to hear more about that in the months to come.
And any thoughts on the Inflation Reduction Act and the impact of that on producers of critical materials?
You know, it's an enormously impactful piece of legislation, you know, not only for our company, but for, you know, the electric vehicle and battery materials industry overall. You know, there's more than $350 billion that is earmarked for, you know, critical material production. The expansion of the tax credit for clean vehicles at $7,500 per vehicle is obviously going to drive adoption, and it's going to drive demand for battery materials. There's also some material tax benefits in that act that will directly positively impact our company. So you can expect us to be speaking more about that in the days to come.
Hold tight for that conversation. I'm sure we will be speaking very soon. Thank you very much for the update today.
Our pleasure.
Thanks for having us.
Terence Cryan is the executive chairman, Stephen Cates, the incoming chief financial officer at Westwater Resources.